Hello, I have another little flashlight that I've bought. This one is rather small. It's the Fenix E03R. All metal keychain flashlight. There you go, it's in focus. It charges up via USB-C. It only weighs 22 grams. It's 260 maximum lumens with a maximum beam distance of 42 meters. So this isn't for long range work. This is something very light, very small, just to keep with you. And it's an all metal housing. And it comes with white and red LEDs, which I shall show you in a minute. So have a look at the info. Alright, so we've got high mode is 260 lumens, and that'll only last you for 45 minutes with a beam of 42 meters. Medium is 80 lumens for 1 hour 15 minutes for 25 meters. Low mode is 30 lumens for 3 hours at 16 meters distance. And eco is 5 lumens for 18 hours and 7 meters, I should say. If you go into red mode, that's only 4 lumens, and that'll last you for 5 hours, 30 minutes, for 10 meter beam range. And the red flash, that's just the same thing, 4 lumens. So, it's IP66, I believe. Yeah, IP66 rated, impact resistant, 1 meter. So let's have a little look. It's very small, I've got it engraved with my name. It's very lightweight. It comes with only a little split ring, so you can install the split ring and it'll be like that, so when you put it on your keychain it will go flat. But I've done a little test. You don't get a ball bead chain with it, but just for reference point, it will fit on a ball bead chain, which is actually kind of nice. So that's a little bonus bit of information for you. So the interface is pretty simple. You just press it once to see what the battery level is, and that'll either be green solid, green flashing, red solid, or red flashing. And as it gradually goes further down in those, you need to start thinking about charging it soon. So you hold the button down to turn it on, and if you let go as soon as the white light comes on, then it'll only be in white light. If you hold the button down a little bit longer, then it goes into red. So once you've turned on your light, then you just tap the button to go up the modes. So it starts in eco, then low, medium, high. And when you finish with the light and you want to turn it off, you hold the button down again. And when the light goes off, you let go. If you don't let go, that will put it in red mode. So as I was saying the first time, if you let go when you're turning it on, once it's on, it'll stay in just white, but if you keep going, it goes in red. So I'll show you that. So now we're in red mode, and then if you press it once, it will go into red flashing. So you could set this down on a wall in an emergency and maybe draw some attention at the roadside perhaps, and then press again to change the mode back. And then if you hold the button down, it will switch it off. Now, when you're actually in white light mode, okay, so we're in white light mode. Now, if I hold the button down, it goes off, but if you hold it, then it will go into red. And again, you just hold the button down to turn it off. It's quite a simple user interface, but it works. And it's a very nice looking, very nice feeling, very lightweight and quite thin light. You could stick that in your pocket, and you wouldn't realize it was there really. You can also do a lockout on this, so you can tap it twice and it will shine twice to let you know. And so now, in order to turn the light on, you need to tap it twice to undo that lock, and then it works from that point just in the normal way. The lock is no longer on once you've turned it on with that double tap. So there you go. Let's have a little look at what it's like outside. Hello, this is the nighttime portion of the Fenix E03R. Now, this is, it starts from eco and goes up to high. This is eco mode, and while my eyes aren't exactly dark adapted right now, I can see enough to not trip up on an object. It's not very bright and it's not enough for me. So let's have a look at the next mode. Here's low mode. Now I can make do with this. And this will be just bright enough for kind of close range tasks, walking around while preserving some battery life. So that's low mode. Here's medium mode. And now we're getting to the point where we're using more battery power, but if we really need to see it a little bit further distance, we can do. And then high mode. I would only use this for short bursts. Perhaps if you're walking from a building to your car or something. It does have a little bit of range. I can see all the way to the end where the fences are. Not in great detail, but enough that I could see if there was somebody there. So that's it. Let's have a quick look at the red mode. Okay, so this is the red one. And it's not as broad beam. It does have a bit of a concentrated beam. I would say, though, that this is not the best solution for walking around because it is very condensed, doesn't have much in the way of spill. And with it being red, while it does help you to preserve your night-adapted vision, it doesn't help you to see very clearly. So I would say that this is good for kind of map reading type of thing, looking at things. But the red bulb is not as energy efficient as the white one. So I would stick with low mode, or eco I should say, this one, if you're reading, rather than the red one, unless you are happy using the extra battery power for the aspect of saving your night vision. So there you go, it's a nice small little light, does the job very well. It's hanging waist height on my keys. So yeah, there you go. Please like, subscribe, and I'll see you on whatever the next video happens to be about. Thank you.